The town of Swansboro is making improvements to its downtown parks, including bringing back a place for local fishermen to gather. WNCT's Elizabeth Tu gives us a glimpse at the new changes.
After being out of service for over a year, talk of the return of Swansboro's only fishing pier is gaining support among residents. The pier was closed back in 2015 after concerns about its safety, forcing residents to fish here along the water's edge. But thanks to nearly $200,000 in grants from the Coastal Recreation Fishing License and CAMA, it's on its way back. This is your first look at the proposed pier.
There'll be alternating heights for the railing that will allow for fishing from, you know, a mobility device, fishing by small children. There'll be benches, a new fish cleaning station, as well as pedestrian viewing areas where people can just sit and hang out and look out onto the White Oak River.
Residents say it's been a long time coming.
The amount of space they could bring will just bring more people there. There's nowhere, if you look at it, no public place to fish. So the town opened up a great idea and a great spot for people.
Phase one was completed last year and included the new kayak launch. Other changes in store for Bicentennial Park include landscaping and a trellis for bench swings. Elsewhere at Ward Shore Park, a nearly $25,000 grant matched by the town will create a living shoreline.
What we'll actually do is we'll remove the seawall and we'll do some backfilling, and over time we'll do seagrass plantings and things like that.
The shoreline will prevent erosion of the park. A permit application is underway for that work. The town is currently working on completing the final design stages of the pier and expects it to be open in 2018. In Swansboro, Elizabeth Tu, 9 on your side.
In total, the town received over $265,000 in grants for the updates to its parks. Those funds were matched locally by $94,000.